Greetings, everyone. Well, today we have a special Timey-Wimey Tuesday package opening for you. I got a big honking package from deepest, darkest Britain from David Bunch of Numbers. And since he usually sends me some Doctor Who stuff, I figured we'd wear the Doctor Who shirt and do this on a Tuesday. So let's see what he sent this time around today on the Multimedia Chronicles. Welcome back. Alrighty. Now, David's packages are always epic and special and notable in some way. He's been watching my updates very carefully for months now, and he would always leave a comment to the effect of, okay, good, that's not one of the things I got you. It's like, okay, good, that's not one of the things I got you, because he knows I'm looking for certain things, and he's in constant fear that I'm going to end up buying it and not realize that he's already got it for me, and yeah, so... So far, so good. As far as I'm aware, I haven't accidentally purchased any of the things that are in this package. So let's see what he sent here. So I'm just going to open it up. Alrighty. So we got... oh, it feels like some books. Let's see what we got here. We got... oh, sweet! He's filling in some gaps in my novelization section. We have The Ultimate Evil from the Missing Episodes Collection. This is one of the novelizations of one of the scripts that was written for the never-produced season 23, which would have been Colin Baker, the Sixth Doctor's second season. Very cool. I've been looking for these and have thus far been unable to find any of them. One of the local stores actually had Mission to Magnus recently, but I didn't have any money on me at the time, so I wasn't able to get it. And, oh well. I'll get it eventually. But this is great. Great stuff. Sort of the Sixth Doctor adventures that never were. Eventually, Big Finish Productions did audio adaptations of most of the missing stories that would have been in that season. But there was like one they couldn't get the rights to or something like that. And we have The Ultimate Evil. I'm not sure why he sent me two of the same one, but okay. Now I have it twice over. Oh, okay. Oh, I see. Hold on a second. This one is autographed. Holy shit. This is autographed. Okay. To Tony, fellow founder of the Sausage Club, Wally K. Daly. That, okay, this must be why he sent me this one, like, as a collector's item, because it's signed by the author. And obviously a very personal message to whoever Tony was. That is pretty cool, actually. Very nice. I don't have any Doctor Who novelizations that are autographed by the author. This one isn't autographed as well, is it? No, okay. So I guess this will be the reading copy. This will be the keep it as a collector's item copy. I understand. There is always method to the madness. David does not do anything by accident. Next up, we have another book here. We have... Oh, sweet! Sweet! This is the original edition. We have the Jon Pertwee edition of The Making of Doctor Who. This is really cool. This is like a super, super rare one to have. When was this published? This is 1972. Yeah, because I have the later edition of this. Where is it here? Yeah, this one here, which was the Tom Baker edition. So I don't know how different they are in terms of the contents, but I always wanted to get this one as well because this is the original edition, and this is like a reprint with some modifications and stuff. What is it? This one came out in 1976, so this is 4 years later during Tom Baker's era. That is so cool. Thank you so, so much. I imagine the pictures in the middle are probably all different. Yeah, because they have a photo section in the middle here. And, yeah, so more of like the First Doctor and the Third Doctor there. And got the Second Doctor. Very cool. And then... is there another page there? Yeah, there's another page there. And you got the Third Doctor, of course, and the Master and the Brigadier. But then if we look at the photos in the middle here, it's, oh yeah, they're all different. Like right away, it's all Fourth Doctor pictures. That's interesting. Yeah, no, all There's a little bit of third Doctor stuff, but mostly very fourth Doctor centric. Oh, yeah, yeah. No, quite a difference indeed. Yeah, it's going to be really interesting to read this version and see how different it is from the other one. Very cool stuff. And let's see, we got another book here. We have, oh, well, Speak of the Devil. We have Mission to Magnus. Another one of the missing adventures. Very, very cool by Philip Martin. So this features... This looks like the Ice Warriors, and Syl was going to return. Oh, such a shame. We won't get to see Nabil Shaban as Syl one last time. That would have been a lot of fun. Very, very cool indeed. And let's see here. What else we got? Any other books, or is this all DVDs? I think the rest is all DVDs. Okay, so next up we have a DVD of... Oh, sweet. This is cool. We did not get this here, and I gather you knew that. We just got the regular Bare Bones edition. We have the recently released special edition of The Enemy of the World, which, of course, is one of the nine episodes that were recently rediscovered back in 2013 for the 50th anniversary. They discovered all six episodes of Enemy of the World and released a quick sort of bare bones release. So this one has a whole pile of extras on it. It's got audio commentary with Fraser Hines, Mary Peach, Milton Johns, Gordon Faith, and Sylvia James. Treasures Lost and Found. Cast and crew recall the making of this story. Recovering the Past, a 2018 Philip Morris interview. Remembering Deborah Watling, tribute documentary, restoration featurette, John Pertwee, 1991 introduction, production information subtitles, 1967 BBC One trailer, scripts and Radio Times listings, and photo gallery. Wow, well that's way more deluxe than the one we got here. I'll show you the one we got here. Let me see here, where is it? Yeah, here it is. We did get, it was a little bit deluxe in that we got a... I don't know how widespread this was, but I know here in Canada, we got a slipcover with it, and then we had just the regular edition here. But as you can see on the back, there's no extras at all. It's just the story and nothing else. So that is very, very cool. Let's just crack this open real quick here, because I know the UK ones usually have inserts and stuff with them. So let me just see. It's nice that they gave this one the deluxe treatment, because obviously this was a pretty major find. And, and there we go. Look at this. So we got a nice two-disc set. Very nice. And an insert. Wow, that's great. I really wish we got these inserts with the Region 1 releases, but alas, we did not. But that is so cool. That is amazing. Thank you so much. All right, let's see what other goodies we got here. We got a few more. We have... Oh, sweet! We have the original DVD release of Spearhead from Space. That is very cool. So this is... I think I know the reason he sent this is because there was a music track in this specifically during the factory scene. I think it's in episode one. Where originally it had a piece of music, I think it was a Crosby, Stills, and Nash instrumental piece, and they weren't able to get the rights to that for the Region 1 edition here. So instead, Mark Ayers actually found the original audio from all the stock footage of the factory footage that they used, so they just put in the original audio, which is cool. I mean, it's cool to have as an alternative track, and it works just as well. But very cool to have this. I think subsequent releases, they actually did get the rights to the music tracks. They were able to include that. I'm pretty sure the Blu-ray edition has the music track, if I'm not mistaken. But very, very cool to have that. Certainly, because, I mean, that was the first time that it had the proper DVD release and everything. Oh, my God. Oh, dude. This one we definitely did not get. We only got this on DVD here. We have Power of the Daleks, the animated reconstruction of the Second Doctor's first story. And we have... It's a four-disc set. We got the Blu-ray in color and black and white. And also on DVD. This is so cool. Let's crack this open right now. Just hold on a second here. Crack it open. Ugh. Oh, this is beautiful. Yeah, now this one I know is region B locked, but I do plan to get a region free player at some point. So if we open it up here, so we get a nice wraparound cover. Very nice. And then inside, doesn't look like much in the way of artwork on the inside. Yeah, it's just kind of a landscape there. But we have, oh, there we go. So we got the DVDs and the Blu-rays. So that's very cool. We did not get this on Blu-ray here, so that's very cool. And then in the sort of, it's kind of like a sleeve that it goes into, we have this big booklet. Very nice. All kinds of goodies about that. Yeah, I know we didn't get any of this here. I think this was a Zavi exclusive thing here. We got a few photos there. Very, very cool. But that's awesome. Thank you so much. That'll make a nice companion to my Shada Blu-ray, which is the same format. It has like this sort of slip case that it slides into. And then finally, last but most certainly not least, oh, yes. Yes. I've definitely been wanting this one. This is a fan film that has since been recognized as official canon. We have Downtime, yeah, which features Sarah Jane Smith, the Brigadier, and Victoria, basically, doing battle with the Yeti one more time. Very, very cool. All the original actors return, and this is just fantastic. I'm just going to quickly crack this open here. And, open, says me. Come on. Why will this not open? There we go. We got it. So this is basically a direct sequel to The Abominable Snowman and The Web of Fear. This is, I believe, a Region B, or sorry, Region 2 DVD, but because it's a DVD, I can actually watch it on the computer. I don't have region issues with the computer. So two-disc set. So the original movie, and then... how long is the movie? It doesn't actually say. I think it's about an hour long. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. No, it's... holy crap. They got a 77-minute making of documentary and a 7-minute look at the post-production work on it. So very, very cool. Thank you so much. That's definitely going to make a great addition to the collection. Wow, that is some epic... Glad I wore the Doctor Who shirt. That's all Doctor Who, man. And then, of course, he always sends me a message, an audio message on the USB stick. So I'll be sure to give that a listen a little later. Wow. Thank you so much, David. That is fantastic. Like, that is some really, like, pure class additions to the collection. I really appreciate that a lot, man. That's awesome. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Alrighty, folks. Well, that is it for me to you for now. So until next time, thank you very much for watching. Big thanks to my Patreon sponsors. And be sure to catch me on Twitch. I stream all the time. And we'll see you next time. Until then, sayonara. Hold it. Before you go, a couple of little additions here. I listened to the audio message that David sent me. And thank you very much, David. Always informative and entertaining, as always. And he actually explained a couple of things. I had taken my best guess during the package opening, but he explained a couple things specifically about why he sent two copies of The Ultimate Evil and what the significance of this edition of Spirit Heard from Space was. First off, I got the band name wrong. It was not a Crosby, Stills, and Nash song in the factory scene. It was a Fleetwood Mac song. And the reason he sent this is the edition that has the original factory noises, not the song. And because he pays such close attention to what's in my collection, I got to give him mad props for that, for being so attentive. He mentioned that I already have the Nightmare Fair of the missing episodes. I had forgotten that I have that one. So it's like, I swear he knows my collection better than I do. Anyway, so now I've got Mission to Magnus, the Nightmare Fair, and the Ultimate Evil, which I believe are the only three that were actually novelized out of that never made season. And then... Big Finish did a couple of additional ones on top of that. And then I think there was one that they couldn't get the rights to. I think it was Yellow Fever and How to Cure It. Just because of the characters that were in it, it wasn't too easy to do. But anyway, yeah. So, the reason he sent two copies of The Ultimate Evil was this one has... Let's see here. Here it is. big ink smudge on it, but that's fine. It doesn't really obscure anything major. But the main reason was here on pages 72 and 73, there's like a printing error with like huge chunks of text just wiped out of existence. So if we go here to, what is it, page 65? Yeah, here there's no ink smudge. And then if we go to pages 72 and 73, all the text is intact. And then, as an added bonus, of course, it is autographed to good old Tony, fellow founder of the Sausage Club, by the the author Wally K. Daly. So, I don't know, on the off chance that Wally K. Daly or Tony happen to be watching, can you please let us know what the significance of the Sausage Club is? We're all really curious about that. So, that was it. And basically, just because he had no use for having another copy of it, he sent me both copies, sort of this as a curiosity collector's item edition with the printing error, and then this one as the actual fully readable version autographed by the author. So very cool indeed. And this for the original Factory Sounds, which are not actually available in any other edition that I am aware of. And that's it. So there you go. Now you can go. Thanks again for watching, and sayonara.